So Echo Fox and Cloud9 both drop a game in week 6 in the NALCS, but they both rebound on the Sunday, and because of that, they're still sitting number 1 and number 2 in your week 6 NA power rankings. They still look a cut above the rest of the competition, even though 100 Thieves, who climb up 2 spots to that 3rd spot, absolutely dismantled Cloud9 in that the first game of week 6. Meteos getting some revenge.
Oh, Meteos getting some revenge, and absolutely Aphromoo has to be the story for me. Aphromoo was stunting on Fools this weekend, coming up with those clutch playmaking supports. Absolutely, the Thresh hooks, the Blitzcrank hooks. I hate it as an ADC watching that, because I know that you're dead, you're gone. So this is the guy that's gonna be picking you off in the clutch moments of games, and he was at it once again. But again, yeah, I do wanna give some credit here to Meteos. Definitely had a great performance against his old team Cloud9 in the victory that 100 Thieves picked up against them. But you're right, Echo Fox, Cloud9, they did drop a game this week, but in the game that they did win this week, both of them looked so dominant against their opponents that they showed once again why they do hold these 1 and 2 spots in our power rankings once again.
Yeah, and 100 Thieves last week, we had them at 5, and we said that was just because the teams below them weren't good. 100 Thieves didn't put up a good performance last week. That's not why they were fifth. It was just the bottom 5 teams did not look good. This week, totally opposite, 2-0 week, and they beat the second best team in NA in Cloud9. Also took down FlyQuest, who for some reason drafted a full poke comp with no frontline. They don't know what the patch is, I guess. Fourth, Team Liquid hanging out there. And listen, I know if Team Liquid's there, TSM could easily be in that fourth spot for me. The only reason
How are you gonna appease the TSM fanboys, Eric? Tell me now.
The only reason Liquid is gonna stay up there is just because of the potential that you've seen them reach in this split. They have already looked like a super solid team. TSM has had little moments. Team Liquid basically had the entire first half of the split where they looked like a top tier team on the same level of Cloud9 and Echo Fox. But right now they don't look at that level. And you saw in that 24 minute debacle where Fox destroyed them.
Yeah, Team Liquid holding on to that fourth spot like always, but it's definitely one that they are just barely holding on to with their performance this past weekend and the ones that have come before that. I like them ahead of Team Solo Mid, because when you think about Team Liquid, you do have to give them credit for these victories that they had earlier in the split, where they were able to close teams out so decisively and so fast with their aggressive plays that they were able to get these, you know, games ending at 25, 27 minutes, where everyone else was going longer than 35 or 40 minutes. And I think that that was one of their key strengths, especially when you look at a team like Team Solo Mid, which has had to rely upon some of these extended games or games where they've had, you know, up to a 10K gold lead and they let someone back into the game and then finally are able to finish them off. So I think that's why I definitely like to see Team Liquid ahead of Team Solo Mid here. And I like Team Solo Mid ahead of Clutch Gaming, someone who I think has shown that they, you know, well, they've won both games against Team Solo Mid, but I thought that Clutch Gaming really showed that they were a step behind these elite level teams like a Cloud9 or an Echo Fox. And I think that that loss kind of has really soured, at least my opinion, on Clutch Gaming being able to come away with enough victories in a best of 5 series against one of these teams in the playoffs, and that's why they find themselves down to number 6 on our power rankings.
Yeah, and they got destroyed by Cloud9 and got a win over CLG, which everyone
CLG
is doing.
We're talking about now.
Yeah, jumping back to that, just Liquid and Team SolMid, there's no question, there's no arguing that TSM didn't have a better week 6 than Team Liquid did, but TSM had further down the standings they had to climb up. You see they're up 2 spots. I bet you by next week they're moving ahead of Liquid, maybe even into that top 3 spot for TSM. But right now, they're hanging out at 5. Clutch at 6, as you mentioned, borderline on that playoff spot. And I mean, for me, the playoffs look pretty set.
Yeah,
some crazy stuff will have to happen for that to change.
Right, definitely a little different than Europe in that situation, where you look at this one and you look at kind of that block set of 1 through 6 and you say, yeah, those are the playoff teams. Those are pretty much everybody that's either shown that they deserve to be in the playoffs, or when you just look at their record, you don't see another team being able to catch them. And even if you really want to get nitpicky and say that, you know, a Clutch Gaming, if you're looking at the record, would be ahead of Team Solo Mid. Team Solo Mid holding onto that last playoff spot, 6-6. Well, they still have a 2-game advantage over Optic Gaming, FlyQuest, and then even more so against CLG and the Golden Guardians, who I don't see them catching. But you know, this is going to be so much for one of these teams that are in the bottom four to catch up to this team and get ahead of them that I just do not see it happening whatsoever.
Yeah, they got to make up two games, and there's only six games left to play, so a lot of work to be done. But the team closest looking into that playoff spot has got to be Optic. They're up one spot from last week. They're still close in a lot of these games. They were pretty handled by TSM in that week. I mean, you saw Bjergsen and Hanser 2v4ing. Oh yeah, in that game.
That Mythy teleport back into that bot lane caught Acadian totally off surprise.
Why? White... Everyone's been getting TP on support. Why is that a surprise?
Crazy thing to be surprised by, but it was definitely, again, as you said, a total domination from TSM in that one. Really a step above. But you see that, yeah, Optic has shown that they've been strong, and I think that, you know, someone like Power of Evil has really shown himself to be, you know, an above average mid laner in North America, and has really shown that he can actually carry some of these performances with Optic Gaming, and I really have liked that. A team FlyQuest that I thought with Fly and Anda really working, and maybe Stunt with Wild Turtle solidifying that support position, I thought they'd be better. They really were not. They have shown that they maybe are not ready for that next step to be considered one of these, you know, top six teams and one of these playoff style teams. They may not be there yet.
Yeah, I like Optic subbing out Zig for Dokla. I mean, Zig was the worst performing top laner in the league. I don't think you could really argue that. So we'll see how that change affects them. FlyQuest, I like what they did last week, but this week they looked rough. Again, that poke comp with the Janna, Nidalee, Caitlyn, and our boy Anda. Yeah, sometimes you gotta eat the hook for your Caitlyn. You know, he flashed out of it two or three times and left Wild Turtle.
Yeah.
Hanging to dry, he died.
Not the same level, but as someone who plays a lot of ADC, I tell you, those are the ones where you're just frustrated, hand in your face, just going, what is going on with my team?
At the same time, you gotta be quicker to flash too, Wild Turtle.
Yeah, no. Okay, well, it's never the ADC's fault, okay? You gotta accept that.
And I could flash it, you should be able to too. Golden Guardians!
Yeah!
We're out! First time in the 2018 Spring Split! They are not the 10th place team on our power rankings.
You gotta trust the process. This is it.
I mean, they've got three wins in like the last five games for them. They're actually looking like a competitive team. They're in some of these games. Lorlo looks great.
I was gonna say, that's the one thing that I think has really turned around for them. Lorlo has really stepped up his performance, and this is somebody who had the ability to do that for this Golden Guardians roster, and one that you thought, you know what, if we can tap into some of that potential and he can start to improve, this could be a roster that starts to definitely get better and start to pick up some more results, and that's exactly what we're seeing. Lorlo stepping up his play, and the results are soon behind for Golden Guardians.
And CLG, I mean, I'm not really sure what to say. It seems like every week there's another new issue that arises with this squad.
This time it definitely, to me, it looks like Darshan. Darshan is not getting the job done. And he's somebody that you're gonna have to rely upon with this team right now. Whether it's gonna be for shot calling or holding his own in the top lane, I wasn't seeing enough of either of those things from him leading to any type of solid performances. Kind of Logic Gaming finding themselves a deserved number 10 in our power rankings.
Yeah, absolutely. Don't think you can really argue it with Golden Guardians winning that matchup this week. But again, in North America, it looks much more cut and dry so far in terms of playoffs. Still six games left, so plenty could happen. You could see maybe someone like Clutch, maybe even 100 Thieves, although they look great this week. Maybe falling out of that playoff spot with great runs by Optic or FlyQuest. But for the time being, those playoff spots look pretty close to set in stone in North America.
Definitely think that North America compared to Europe 1-6 looks very solid, and I'm really, really excited here as we break into these last six games of the split to see how things settle down between that order and see who settles into what slot heading into the playoffs.
Playoff seeding means everything. Gotta get that first round bye, but don't worry, still plenty of games left to figure all that out.
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more esports content.